Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Shweta. Welcome to activity 18. It's about magical to-do list. So I hope you have counted your blessings in the morning itself. And let me ask you one question. That is, do you act or do you react? In order to act, you actually need to know what is 100% important to you, and you need to do planning for it. And in people who are reacting, actually things have become so urgent and important for them that they don't have time for planning, so they just go on reacting. But the difference lies in the result. When you act, you get different result, and when you react, you get different result. So if you want to maximize your result and experience 100 and 1,000 times the joy and happiness of getting the outcomes you want, then you need to act for things. That is, you need to plan out things. To plan the things, say for example, you have 10 or 20 tasks to be done tomorrow. So you will be lying anxious, worried about what can happen, what consequences will go through, you will go through, and will things work properly, etc., etc. So many thoughts are wandering in your brain, so you won't be able to focus. And when you won't be able to focus, you won't utilize whole of your potential. And when you don't utilize whole of your potential and you are not certain, then you will not get the result you want. So planning is very simple. Just make a to-do list. There is a book named Eat the Frog. It says that the frog is the thoughts wandering in your brain, jumping here and there. So book mentions that before you go to sleep, just take a paper and write the list of the things or tasks you need to accomplish tomorrow. And second part of the book mentions that when you get up in the morning and you read the list, so you read only the first point in the list or the first task in the list, and then you work out for the first point in the list or first task, and when you accomplish that particular first task, then you read the second task, and when you accomplish the second one, you read the third one. It's like when you read a single task at one time, your brain get completely focused upon how easily and in a perfect way you can accomplish that particular task. So it is like eat the frog, that is, eat one thing at one time. So the other way or the other method and to like prioritize thing is been mentioned in the book The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. This is the Eisenhower quadrant about setting priorities after you make the to-do list. It states that every action we take fall in one of this quadrant. These are divided into important and non-important and urgent and non-urgent. Stay for this first quadrant, which is important and urgent. Things come in this particular quadrant are the project deadlines, the medical emergency, your computer is crashed, your biggest client have a pressing need, and you have a deadline driven target you need to complete. So it will come into this quadrant, that is important and urgent. And there is a second quadrant that is not urgent but it is important. So things come into this quadrant is everything you do that improves the quality of your work and life. Improve, that is improving relationship or seizing new opportunity or personal development, problem prevention and better planning come into this particular quadrant, that is the second quadrant. Now talking about the third quadrant, that is not important, not urgent, implies there is implication of time pressure over here, that is it is urgent but it is not important. This one is a deceptive one. Say for example, different phone calls, different emails you get and messages you get comes into this particular quadrant, the third quadrant. And the fourth quadrant is literally the time waste quadrant, that is social media or watching television, etc. These are very tempting as it takes a very less effort or no efforts. So how to strategize this thing? They say when the things are urgent and important for you, then you need to do it now, and when the things are not urgent but important to you and which are gonna change your life and quality of your life and like make you act for things, not react for things. So when you want to this, it states that spend most of your time into this particular quadrant. So you don't go into this particular quadrant. So it's like strategizing for this particular quadrant is schedule the things and do it soon. And the third one is it is not important, but it is urgent, like the phone calls and emails. So it states that either reschedule it or delegate it to someone else, to your assistant or people around, so that you get time for the important things. And similarly, the last one is the time waster, that is TV, social media. It states that either you do it later or completely avoid that thing, so that you save time for the urgent and important things in your life.